Now on to the continuing focus on the Bilaspur medical negligence case where 14 women died after botched up sterilization surgeries. Admitting to the lapse, Chhattisgarh Chief Minister Raman Singh had ordered a judicial investigation, even as his own government came under the scanner for allegations of a cover-up. The Chief Minister has assured that all possible angles of the tragedy will be looked into by the inquiry committee. But he maintains that resignation was not the solution and that no one will be shielded in the course of the investigations. State Health Minister Amar Agarwal took moral responsibility for the negligence case but still refused to resign from his post.
आज दो दिन में लगातार मैं वहां गया और मुझे महसूस हुआ कि कहीं ना कहीं जो रीजन था, एक तो ऑपरेशन है, ऑपरेशन के समय जो कमियां रह गई, दूसरा जो दवाइयां दी गई उसका रिएक्शन हुआ. आज हमने ये निर्णय लिया कि जुडिशियल इंक्वायरी भी हो ताकि सारे पक्षों को, सारे तथ्यों को सामने लाया जाए.
While an investigation has been ordered in the Bilaspur tragedy, headlines today spotted what could possibly be key evidence being destroyed in the backyard of the hospital. Piles of ampules, tablet strips and saline bottles were being destroyed in what appeared to be a cover-up.
इस तरीके से सबूतों को नष्ट करने की कोशिशों के पीछे कौन है, किसे बचाने में भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार लगी हुई है?
कोई भी साक्ष्य मिटा नहीं सकता. उसके सैंपल हमने पहले ही जब्त किए हुए हैं, कहां से खरीदी हुई है वो सारा रिकॉर्ड हमारे पास है.
Meanwhile, the arrested Chief Medical Officer Dr. R.K. Gupta has alleged that there was pressure from the top to meet targets set for a sterilization drive. The Union Health Minister, meanwhile, said it was a misconception that family planning is a target-driven program. On the contrary, it's a target-free, promotional and a demand-driven program. We have Aathir Khan joining us on the phone line for more on the story. Aathir, what do we know of the investigations that have been conducted so far into the deaths of these 14 women?
Well, you see, let me inform you first that the government has already taken cognizance of the expose of these medicines being burned, and today and during the last 24 hours, it has been carrying out raids at different places to find out if the cyprosin, the suspected spurious medicine, is available at any shops. And it has also taken into custody the retailer who was responsible for giving these medicines. So the government has taken strict measures in that concern. But as far as the investigation is concerned, that is under the police domain, and it is questioning the doctor in question and trying to find out more facts.
We also understand, Aathir, that the Chhattisgarh Health Department has sealed the factory in Raipur from where these medicines had been sourced. But of course, as you said, that the government is making efforts. They come a little too late. But as far as the investigations against Dr. R.K. Gupta, the Chief Medical Officer, is concerned, how far have those investigations gone and the allegation that he's made that he alone was not responsible for what has happened?
Well, what is startling is that there is a provision under which the CMO of the district can procure some medicines if need be. Now, what apparently seems to be the case is the CMO at the local level has purchased these suspected medicines. Okay. Whose samples have been sent for examination. So that was the multiplying effect which caused perhaps so many deaths. Though we are awaiting the reports, forensic reports and the medical reports, but the police is trying to gather as much evidence to back up this theory so that, when there is a trial,
right,
they have ample of evidence with them.
हमारे दवाओं की हम गवर्नमेंट सप्लाई सीधे नहीं करते हैं. आज तक हमारे द्वारा गवर्नमेंट सप्लाई नहीं की गई है और खुले बाजार में हम ट्रेडर्स को, थोक दवा विक्रेताओं को दवा बिक्री करते हैं और उन दवा विक्रेताओं के द्वारा खुले बाजार में एवं कुछ एक के द्वारा शासकीय आपूर्ति की जाती होगी वो हमारी जानकारी में नहीं होती.
We are just checking the records and taking samples.
How is it happening?